guys, welcome back to another fun project today. Today's project is actually supposed to be fairly straightforward, but the key word here is supposed to be. So in today's video, I'm actually going to be installing one of these things. Audi calls it an air duct. You can actually see the part number right there. I'll actually even put it in the link below in case it makes it easier for you to copy paste it into the search engine. But so yeah, it's supposed to be an air duct. In fact, it even says so. I don't know if you guys can see it. There you go. It's Audi Sport branded, supposedly made in Germany. So the idea of this part is to essentially zip tie on, and I didn't make this up. It actually comes from the factory with these zip ties, these Audi approved zip ties, to essentially zip tie these on to a part of the suspension setup. I guess I'll show it to you a little bit later once I get underneath there, such that once it's essentially latched on or zip tied on, the idea is to channel more air into the front wheel wells or into the brake calipers and the brake discs themselves. And one reason for this is because if you look at the RS3 front brakes, they're actually exceptionally beefy brakes. If I'm not mistaken, these brakes, the front brakes, are actually from the V8 R8 from the previous generation. These are actually fairly beefy brakes. But the problem is that the car itself, as you can see, the RS3 is not a very large car. So the wheel well is not very spacious. So there isn't a whole lot of airflow going into the wheel well to cool the discs and the front brake setup in general, as much as it would be in a larger car, like an RS4 or an RS6 or an R8, which is what this setup is lifted off of. So the fact of the matter is in regular driving, you shouldn't see any difference. Why? Because I've been driving this car for over a year now. I don't track it, and I've not really had any brake issues. But nevertheless, this is a cheap part. If I'm not mistaken, I actually bought this a few months ago. I just haven't gotten around to installing it until now. Each side was about $25 to $30. So not super expensive to begin with. So times two is 60, which is not too bad. And the second thing is if you are planning on tracking the car, or you end up driving the car fairly aggressively, this would probably go a long way in at least somewhat reducing the surface temperature of the discs and the pads and the calipers themselves. So again, should be a fairly straightforward and easy install. I'll actually do one side first, not on the video, to make sure that I get an idea of how it works and how the setup goes, so that when I do it on the other side and capture the video, there are less errors, and hopefully it looks a little bit more polished. So yeah, catch you in a bit. All right, so I'm done with the right side brake duct. Again, as I had expected, the install itself is, I mean, it's super easy. It's just a piece of plastic that's zip tied onto this particular member over here. The issue is orienting yourself, right? So to help you guys out a little bit, one, the boot that you see over there is a component that you can orient yourself around, point number one. Point number two, obviously the wheel well and the brake caliper over there. But more importantly, and I'm going to see if I can show you guys this, it's entirely possible you may not. Okay, there you go, beautiful. You see that little metal component over there? I'm not sure exactly what that is, but you'll see that the brake duct piece has a little U-shape cutout to kind of like work around that particular metal component. So that acts as a great way of helping you figure out the orientation and how this thing, this particular plastic piece, is supposed to fit onto the member over there, right? So that took me a little while to kind of like figure out what exactly the orientation should be and the spacing should be. But if you work your way around that particular U-shape over there, around that particular metal piece, you should be good to go. And after that, it's just a matter of essentially zip tying the pieces down. As you can see over here, there are three pieces, one, two, and three.
The only thing to keep in mind, and I made a mistake over here, and again, so that you guys don't make the mistake, when you're pulling the zip tie out over here from the back, you want to make sure that you pull it through the channel. Let me see if I can show you an example of it done right. There you go. So you can see that the zip tie is actually within the channel, whereas over here, I didn't see it when I was actually tightening the zip tie. It actually slipped out. It's not the end of the world, frankly speaking, but again, it's not as clean as I want it to be. In this case, I'm not going to bother, but if you guys are super kind of like paranoid about stuff like this, you can actually, believe it or not, order these Audi approved in quotes zip ties separately. They cost like a dollar or something, and then just essentially cut this one out and put it through again. But yeah, that's basically it. I'll do the same thing on the other side and slice that into this video.
All right, I'm going to the left side duct right now. So before I actually go in and install it again, so as you can see, there is this U-shaped cutout that essentially slides around that the metal piece over there. So that acts as a good guide. What you also want to do is pull these zip ties out of there. Hold on. Sorry if the video appears a little shaky and jerky. I can't use the gimbal and get underneath the car. So you'll have to bear with me over there. So yeah, you want to make sure first that you essentially remove these zip ties from the guides over there and there, so that all of these zip ties can essentially be pushed up as you position the actual piece around that little member. And once it is done, and it actually is reasonably, so it doesn't clip on to anything, which I really wish it did. It kind of provides an assurance that, hey, it's positioned right, so it won't clip on to anything. But as I mentioned, if you position it right, it should actually, even without the zip ties, not move around a whole lot. So here's the left side duct. It's so I haven't zipped it down yet. I've just positioned it in the right location so that you guys can see what it's supposed to look like. Again, so this is towards the back. That's the back of the car. So you can see that actually, so I mentioned that nothing clips on. That's not entirely true. This is the one kind of piece that, if you look at the distance from that screw over there to this particular plastic, it does kind of like, it doesn't clip, but then it has a little bent where it sort of like latches onto this metal member. So that actually acts as a good guide. So obviously the other side is free floating, because as you can see, I haven't zip tied it down. So now it's entirely possible that when you actually put these or slide these in, the zip ties themselves actually fall off. Not a big problem. It's actually fairly easy to put it back in. Okay, so all right, so with that, both the sides are done. You can see the left over there, so that's clearly visible over there, and you can see the right side duct having been installed over here. As I mentioned, it's actually fairly simple and straightforward, but orienting yourself can be a little bit of a challenge. And again, the only thing that I'll remind you guys is to make sure that you use the guides to align the zip ties and not make the mistake that I made on the right side, where I zipped it too tight without realizing that it's actually not within the guide over there, as you can see. But apart from that, fairly straightforward. And the one thing I just realized, I didn't mention this early on, I'll actually put a little disclaimer up front, is that not all RS3s will have this piece missing. So definitely all North American model year 2017 RS3s won't have this piece. And it looks like some of the early production model year 2018 RS3s, like mine over here, will also have it missing. I think the production date, the month cutoff is September, could potentially be August as well. So if you have an RS3 which was manufactured before August 2017 for the model year 2018, it's highly likely that you don't have this brake duct piece. But yeah, hopefully you guys found this video useful. And as with all other videos, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe.
and also share this video with other friends or colleagues who you think might find it useful. I'm planning on expanding what I cover in this channel. Let me know if you guys find my videos useful. Yeah, let's see what the future holds. Thanks, guys.